Hi guys, just thought I'd make a video on online alternatives to applications that you have on your computer. So, what would the advantages of this be? Well, that means that they can run on all any operating system that has a browser. So you can basically do what you want inside Linux, inside Mac, inside Windows. So I'm just going to be going through some applications that are available. I basically had a look through my start menu and saw looked at, thought about the things I do most, and then looked at some of my previous videos I've made on online alternatives and just thought I'd group them together. So let's get started. Windows Live SkyDrive is what I'm using for storage of files, because instead of using a PC, a hard disk, you can upload your files to the web. So I've just got some folders here and I can put my files in them. So that is Windows Live SkyDrive. Now there are plenty of alternatives to this, and I'm sure there's plenty of alternatives to all the other things I'm going to be showing you, but I'm just going to be showing you what I use. So next up is the Google Docs. Now it's in beta. This is an alternative to Word. As you can see, we've got classic stuff that you'd have in Microsoft Word. Primarily I make Windows videos, so I'm just going to compare it to some Windows applications. So this is an alternative to Word, and obviously you can save it online. And it says when it's edited, could give it a title, revise it, have HTML if you want to, share it, publish it, email it, print it. And the same Google Docs you can have for a spreadsheet, so that's an alternative to an Excel file. So obviously these are going to be a little bit more limited than your applications, so don't expect much, but they're online and they're cross-platform, so hey, well, there's no complaints. This one's a PowerPoint alternative, so making your presentations. Several things with slides here. SplashUp, now this is just going to pop up for a second. This is an alternative to, well, it's a simple alternative to Photoshop. As you can see, it's got like a sort of Photoshop looking box. You can do images, layers, filters, so you can open your images locally or from Facebook, Flickr and all that rubbish. So you can start doing things and then you can catch it from your webcam and save it. So that is SplashUp. Just going to click that. Next one is Pixar. Now this kind of is the same thing. You can upload your images from your PC and then you can add filters to them and change things like saturation. This is what I'd consider to be an alternative to Earth in View, which is a viewer, previewer. And I don't know what this picture is, it's just a demo picture it looks like. So yeah, you can add effects, brightness, saturation, all this stuff to your pictures. Next up, I've talked about this before, it's Splice Music.com, and it's a mixer, and you can basically drag instruments onto here and you can basically mix music and have a long thing of different instruments and then just have it as a mixer, so you can make and remix music. Next up is Jump Cut. Now I've only just joined this, so I haven't got a vague idea of what it does. You can basically remix videos, either your own videos or things like YouTube videos, and you can remix them and add your own effects to them, audio, titles, effects, actions, so add transitions and stuff like that. So yeah, I've only just joined this, but this is kind of a video editor, so you can delete, duplicate, slice, preview, save and exit, publish my remix. So I just randomly chose a video and said remix, so you can add different things to that. Now next one is Net2FTP. Now I use FileZilla on my computer to FTP into my website and access all my documents and files that are on my web server, but you can do this over on the internet with Net2FTP. And as you can see, this is all my stuff I have in my web server, so I can start changing stuff, editing stuff online, so I don't need to worry about downloading an FTP editor. Next up, Dizzler.com, listening to music. So if I was to say, I don't know, Ja Rule, you notice it's come up with several things here. This is Dizzler, and you can basically listen to songs. I've just clicked Always On Time. I'm going to enable this flash thing. I was just going to play this one. There we go. I was playing the first one, doesn't matter. So, just choose your artist. Just choose your artist and it'll play it. So, that seems good enough to me. So it's an alternative to any music player, I suppose. Obviously, you might be able to save them. I don't know if you can actually... oh yeah, you save them as a playlist, I see. But you can listen to them online. Next one is Ustream. So watching live TV, this is just an alternative. Ustream, a lot of different free things that you can get that people broadcast on here. Obviously YouTube is an alternative as well to watching videos, because that's an online service. So Ustream here, live as well, so good live stuff. Bebo is an online alternative to things like AIM, MSN Messenger, Yahoo Messenger, Google Talk. So you can just log into your various things. I'll just quickly log into my one. My test account anyway. Oops. And it should give me should sign on and give me all my contacts. Well, I've only got two, so. And eventually we're gonna get anywhere. Okay, in the meantime, mail to web, I'm using as an IMAP client because I usually use Thunderbird for my email, and that's my inbox for my email. Now, you can actually access this over the internet, and you can have mailtoweb.com. I'll provide all the links to all of these in the description. So this can actually pick up my email from the internet, and obviously I've got my original Fastmail. If I go on fastmail.fm, I can check my emails anyway, but this is just a way to do it with IMAP. So if you really want to do it, you can do that. And then the last two, I'm just going to talk about games. VNES, Virtual NES, you can just play a game if you really want to. This is an alternative to emulators that you have on your computer. I've talked about it before, you just click a game and it will load the game up as if it's a NES. Now, you don't expect to play PSP games on the internet or PS3 or anything like that. It's just very old games that you can play. And have we loaded Amiibo yet? I hasn't logged in. Perhaps I check my password. Okay, I haven't put my password in. Let's not worry about that. The last one is Fossbar, which again is my favourite. It's an alternative to things like Unreal Tournament or Quake, where you can just basically play a game in proper 3D. You probably can't see this very well. But yeah, you can sort of play a 3D game. So I'll just show you the graphics there quickly because that wasn't a very good rendering. Still got 66 frames per second. I've got a machine gun and it's all in 3D. So these are all online alternatives to applications that you'll probably find on your computer. And again, I'll link put all the links in the description so you know about each of them. And you can try them all out if you want to try them. So regardless of if you're on Linux, Mac or Windows, you can use all of these because they run in your browser. So, thanks for watching my video. Please comment, rate, subscribe if you like my videos, and thanks again.